same as a persecution real quick. And that's where we left off. We left off of a man named Septimus Servius, right? Because last time we talked about, what's his name? Last time we talked about a man by the name of Antius Pius. He's the one who killed Polycarp. He's the one who warned Polycarp and Trajan. He's a Christian. He didn't seek after them. He refused, but they whoever refused to deny Christ, he would destroy them. But now we're going to carry on with Septimus Servius. Now, Septimus Servius was reigning in 193 to 211, and he localized persecutions in Egypt and North Africa. And I have something right here that reads about his autobiography, because I forgot my book like a dummy. It says, Septimus Servius, another emperor under whom Christians suffered terribly, Septimus Servius, who ruled from 193, boom chakalaka, to 211. During the reign of Cleopatra Alexandria, said many martyrs are daily burned, confined, or beheaded before our eyes. Okay? In 202, he enacted a law prohibiting the spread of Christianity and Judaism. But you see, the problem is, though, when he did that, when he was going to Africa and Egypt, this was before Nero, okay? During that time under Nero in AD 64, Peter read the writings of, I believe it was Paul or something like that, and then they started to spread because of the persecution. Now, this is really good because in Matthew chapter 10, verse 23, I believe, it says, when persecution comes, flee to another city. Because of the persecution, we're gonna look into soon, the results of persecution is starting to spread, not only from Jerusalem, but also it started spreading into Africa and also in Egypt. And guess who wanted to stop that? Most of the emperors as well. That's why they were over there, you know? Sean, if you're being bullied, you'd be probably going someplace else, right? Mm-hmm. And that's what was going on. He was starting to kill these people. And after his reign, he was starting to kill not only Christians, but he also started killing off Alexandrians who in a sense, they were Christians, but they had like, I don't think they even were Christians, but the people classified them as Christians, but their main leader of that was Origen. In Origen, he believed in Gnosticism. And Gnosticism is a belief where everything on this world is earthly, everything spiritually, stuff like that. And that's not a great idea. Septimus Servius, who was really wicked, that's what he did with the Christians. Killed them, burned them at the stake, localized persecution, also in Egypt and North Africa. Now we have a man by the name of Maximinus, okay? Now Maximinus, he localized persecution, but he focused on the Christian leadership. Okay, people were being sent into churches and also poisoning the leaders of the church, pastors, stuff like that. They were round them in, killing them. They were also sending out spies, but what he means by focus on the Christian leadership, he basically focused on the shepherd. Okay, he thought that if you kill the shepherd, the sheep will scatter. And they did, but what he did know, the sheep start banging, and everyone else start banging too with the gospel, you know? So during his persecution raised by Maximinus, numberless Christians were slain without trial and buried in heaps, sometimes 50 or 60 being cast into a pit together without the least decency. The time Maximinus dying in 238 was succeeded by Gordian, during whose reign and that of his successor Philip, where the church was free from persecution for the space of more than 10 years, so it's spaced out after him. Going into Decius, now this is really just really dumb, guys. You guys are gonna be like shocked about this. Decius, he reigned from 247 to 251. He blamed Christians for the Roman plague when they failed to celebrate Rome's birthday. Not only that too, he wanted sacrifices to his name. This man was a great warrior tactician. He killed a lot of people in the Arab and all that stuff. Great warrior tactician. But he demanded worship and wanted the Christians to sacrifice to his name, and he demanded worship on his birthday. But of course, what did the Christians do? They denied it, okay? And when they denied it, guess what? He started killing them off, and he required sacrifices of allegiance to Rome, and as a certificate of getting away from persecution. Like, Kevin, if I didn't want you to die, okay, you're a Christian, okay, how about this? Since you didn't want to celebrate my birthday, how about you sacrifice something to me? Okay, if you don't do it, you'll die. That's kind of like your escape from that. Valerian, he continued, disused his policies, blaming Christians for natural calamities. That means if someone sneezes, he's going to die. Now, I'm being dead serious. And you know what's so funny? You look at this world today, Man, they started blaming Christians for every single disease out there right now. I'm serious. They blame in Africa. I think they were killing them off because they were complaining their crops were missing or something like that. Seriously, it goes around. What goes around, this comes around. Like, come on. And Diocletian, it was the most severe of all persecutions. From 303 to 313, I'm almost done. I have like 3-4 minutes left. He was the severest of all persecution. He destroyed places of worship, burned sacred books, imprisoned the clergy, revoked Christian Roman citizenship, that to the point where some of them wanted to come in, they will actually look and say, no, you're not allowed to enter Roman. Why? Because they wanted Roman to be free of Christianity. That's why Paul had a burden to go back to Rome. And Paul used his Roman citizenship and said, hey, I am a Roman citizen. And he had the right to say it too. But you see, but you notice where this is actually like, where I'm going with this? Revoke Christian Roman citizenship. You notice that this present world today doesn't like Christians at all? They don't love Christians at all. And guys, we learn history not to repeat it, but to learn from it. We look at this stuff, people are killing off Christians. Doesn't want anything to do with them. And during this time, Rome was falling in big time to the deep end. Why? Because those small remnant they were killing off, they were basically taking a flame, putting it under the bush, and that thing was just dying out, dying out, dying out. And God loved them so much to even have those people there. And they were just killing them off. They have nothing to do with them. They wanted them gone. Look at America today. They have nothing to do with Jesus. They have nothing to do with Christians. We're the most hated people. And I keep telling people, well, how do you know your religion is true? How many people died believing in Muhammad and all that, Buddhism, Islam, all that other stuff? How many people died? I'm not talking about, well, I'm going to blow myself up. No, I'm talking about how many people died actually proclaiming the name of Muhammad. Not one.
That's good. Amen.
Right.
That's how we know that this stuff is true. And what was the results of this? The results of persecution was the expansion of Christianity. Guys, we know how we got here. We know how Christianity spread because of the people that were scattered in the book of Acts. Mm-hmm. When they're being persecuted, they scattered. Guys, when you're out there soul-winning, knocking on doors, whatever, and people are just discouraging you, guess what? If they're not welcome there, then get out. Mm-hmm. Go to another place.
Right.
Go to another place and plant a seed there.
Right.
The Bible says so shall thy words be that go forth out of thy mouth, and that shall not return unto me void. That means if you give a gospel tract to somebody and they crumble up and throw it away, it's going to blow down the street and somebody else is going to get it. That's what he's saying.
Right.
We're out there going somewhere, just keep spreading the gospel. The results of persecution, the recognition of the New Testament canon. People were looking through it and they started recognizing it more. That's why during this time frame, people like, you know, King James and all this other stuff, during another period, during the persecution, they realized that this Bible, it was something true. And people started hiding it. People started, like Diocletian, people started burning it. Like, well, how is he burning it? Because it holds the true words of God, and it was recognized by a man named Peter. Peter recognized Paul's writing as scripture in 2 Peter 3:15 through 16 in AD 64 during persecution. Okay? So that's something good. We're going to leave off from there for next week. We're going to be in the book of Smyrna for a while. I feel like until God comes back. So remember that, guys. We'll come back next week again.